Welcome to the Windows Club. If you encounter the file Explorer.exe application error on your Windows computer, then either read through this article on the Windows Club or simply watch this video. I'll guide you to the resolutions. First of all, you need to restart the file Explorer. Search for Task Manager in the Windows search bar and click on this application to open it. You'll find the Windows Explorer process. Right click on it and select restart. The next solution would be to change the size of the virtual memory. Ideally, it should be 1.5 times larger than your RAM memory. Now, I know that my system has a RAM of 4 GB, which means the virtual memory should be 6 GB. So search for performance in the Windows search bar and click on this option which says adjust the appearance and performance of Windows. In this window, go to the Advanced tab. Under Virtual Memory, click on Change. Now, the virtual memory for my system is around 7 GB and it should be around 6 GB. I can change it using this. The next solution would be to disable fast startup. Press the Windows key and the R button together to open the run window. Type the command powercfg.cpl and hit enter. This will open the power options window. Now go to this option which says choose what the power button does. After this, you'll find this option for turning on fast startup. Uncheck this one. The next solution would be to run the SFC scan. For this, search for command prompt in the Windows search bar and click on run as administrator in the right pane to open the elevated command prompt window. In the elevated command prompt window, type the command SFC space forward slash scan now and hit enter to invoke the SFC scan. This will check for missing and corrupt files and replace them if possible. Similarly, you can perform a check disk operation which will check for bad sectors on your hard drive and repair them. Go to the same elevated command prompt window and this time type the command CHKDSK space forward slash R space forward slash F and hit enter. The next solution would be to update the Microsoft .NET framework. Go to .NET.microsoft.com and you'll get an option to download the latest .NET framework. The sixth solution would be to run the Windows Memory Diagnostic tool. For this, press the Windows key and the R button together to open the run window. Type the command mdsched.exe and hit enter. This will open the Windows Memory Diagnostic tool and here click on restart now and check for problems. If this does not help, then you can also scan your system for malware. Isn't this easy and interesting? If you have any doubts, please go to the original article on the Windows Club, scroll down to the comment section and write your query. We will surely answer to it. Do not forget to subscribe to the channel. Thank you for watching this video and have a nice day.